Orpheus Taelos serves as a captain of the Imperial Fists chapter during the 41st millennium. A veteran commander with experience leading the chapter's 2nd, 10th, and currently 7th company, there are few Astartes with a similar pedigree as Taelos. His stratagems during the Nimbosa Crusade proving crucial in defeating the Tau Empire, Orpheus oversaw the initial diplomatic negotiations as a military advisor. Rallying his forces as the ruse of peace talks protracted, alongside the High Marshal of the Black Templars, Helbrecht, the Sons of Dawn liberated the planet. Their victory against the commander, known as Bright Sword, costing the lives of the entire Vestroian Firstborn defenders and native population, Orpheus' own forces would incur casualties. The Battle of Koloth Gorge, the most catastrophic, many men of the Second Company endured a 3-hour crossfire as the Tau massacred their reinforcements of Imperial Guardsmen. Injured during the battle, Taelos witnessed the deaths of his men firsthand, and with the conclusion of the war, surrendered his command of the Scions of Redemption. Emotionally tormented for his failure, the anguish felt for the loss of his men further exacerbated his mental state. Blaming himself for the genocide of Nimbosa's population, Taelos sought to embark upon a warrior pilgrimage with sanction from the chapter master, Vladimir Pugh. Denying his request, the chapter master reassigned Orpheus to lead the 10th company, the Eyes of Dawn. Understanding the honor inherent in fostering new generations of Astartes into the fold of the chapter, Taelos nevertheless felt a pang of shame in losing his command of a battle company. Atoning for his past failure, for 4 Terran standard years, Orpheus trained new recruits of the chapter and took to the field at the head of Task Force Gauntlet. Fighting the Emperor's children and their allied Roaring Blades Straighter Guardsmen, the 10th Company under Taelos liberated the planet of Vernalis alongside elements of the 1st and 5th Battle Companies. Earning the right to command the 7th Battle Company, the Guardians of the Phalanx, Taelos began his vigil aboard the Fortress Monastery of the Chapter. Aided by the Adeptus Custodes with technologies from the dark cells of the Imperial Palace to refit the ancient flagship, despite valuing their prompt support, Taelos nonetheless became wary of such freely given aid from the Golden Host. Tasking the Praetor Colonel of the Auric Auxilia, Talia Kask, to investigate the origins of such technologies, Taelos cannot allow for his charge to be exploited should such artifacts turn on their masters. To this day, Orpheus Taelos defends the Phalanx from the enemies of the 7th, yet never again will allow for his charges to fall while he draws breath.